Well, he is loud, he's brash, and he's trying to dominate the country's radio ratings with his unique broadcasting style. This morning, the Kyle and Jackie O Show launched in Melbourne in their bid for global domination.
After months of build-up, Kyle Sanderland's and Jackie Henderson's big day has arrived.
The day of the revolution, the beginning of the 20-year dream of going national.
Their Kiss FM show playing all their classic hyper-sexualised hits to a new Melbourne market.
You're Thank a you. Massive homo. Have you ever had sex with a paparazzi? You got you got a tiny
yes,
penis?
Yes, I've got a very tiny penis.
Melburnians had thoughts.
Do you think they will go down well in Melbourne?
I do.
Yeah, they're good. Yeah, Kyle's funny. Yeah.
I don't listen to Kyle and Jackie O. I don't love what they do.
They kind of teeter on the edge of going too far.
They are super opinionated, very jarring. I don't think it's probably going to gel well with the Melbourne vibe.
I'm a fuel-guzzling, the ex-F-boy, coke-sniffing asshole. That's what I am.
I won't listen to that. Because we just don't need it.
Kyle and Jackie dominate Sydney radio with an audience of around 850,000 listeners and each earning roughly $10 million per year.
See you later, loser.
But valued at around $220 million, Melbourne is Oz Radio's most lucrative market. And it's got 2.3 million breakfast radio listeners that Kyle is now officially trying to win over.
There's no way in the world this won't work. There'll be plenty of people that will hear the show and will absolutely love it. And there will be just as many that will be repulsed. Well, maybe not just as many. I guess that's the math they're trying to do.
When he's not guzzling fuel or sniffing things, Kyle can court controversy. He's breached broadcasting standards and offended the country on several occasions. Fat shaming, labelling the Paralympics horrific, inadvertently pressuring a 14-year-old into revealing she'd been raped and making offensive comments towards gay men.
The monkeypox, the big gay disease floating around. It's only the gays getting it.
Kiss owners ARN Media are spending between $4 and $6 million launching the duo into Melbourne. We think at least $1 million went into this cake they sent us.
Kyle has no intention of picking an AFL team. He's not going to ride a tram. And if they can win without having any Melbourne reference points on their show, then really everything changes from a radio perspective.